I have from Dimitris Angelidis, Εφημερίδα των Συντακτών, a delegation of the Labour Committee witnessed yesterday what seems to be a pushback operation in Samos. Five Somalis were hiding in the woods. The police had no identification numbers and had their faces covered. The guys said they had lost the traces of 19 more people and that they heard gunshots. Is there any news about what happened to the rest of the group of refugees in Samos? Minister, first to you, what actions has the government taken to investigate these cases?
Thank you. First of all, let me be very clear. European Union member states have an obligation, a sovereign obligation, to protect the external borders of the European Union according to the Schengen Acquis and according to the principle of sovereign rights. The most recent decision from the European Court of Human Rights in a case against Spain upheld that countries have the right, under condition and under specific rules, to protect their borders. So the principle that countries do not have borders is not something that the Greek government will agree to. These borders exist. People have passports to travel, and people get visas to travel to countries where it requires visa. So if there are people that think the world should not have borders, this is not the position of the Greek government, and probably is not the position of any government of the European Union. Protecting the border requires adherence to international law. And I couldn't agree more with President Aguilar that member states have to protect their external borders in full respect of fundamental rights of those seeking international protection to the European Union. And Greece does exactly that. And we have welcomed 100,000 people in the last 3 years in Greece, over 1 million people in the last 7 years, over 1 million people in the 90s. So Greece is no stranger to migration, is no stranger to having people seeking international protection in our country. Of course, at the European Union level, we very much advocate that Europe needs to have legal pathways to migration and not allow the smugglers to decide who comes to the European Union. Talking about the situation with Afghanistan, you know Greece recently provided 700 humanitarian visas to provide a safe passage to Greece and asylum to Greece if they choose so to people that are in need of protection. So we are protecting our borders. You refer to an investigative journalist piece about allegation to the Greek authorities from an NGO called Lighthouse. I have written to them and have asked them to provide further information, detailed information about the videos, and provide witnesses to the authorities so we can properly investigate. They have responded in writing that they will provide no further information other than the one they published in their website. This information has now gone to the Greek Independent Transparency Agency for examination. I'm surprised that the authors of this report are not willing to share with the competent authorities, not with me, not with the ministry, the detailed information and the witnesses they claim to have, which will help the authorities to investigate. Now, going to the point about an independent monitoring mechanism, I have to say Greece already operates three independent monitoring mechanisms. We have the national independent authorities that have the jurisdiction to control the performance of the civil servants and government. We have the internal audit of the police, which is being supervised by an attorney general, so it is under judicial review and not under administrative review. And of course, we have the judiciary. And the rule of law means exactly that, that the government does not intervene in the process of the judiciary. What I think is not needed is to create a special mechanism which is not under the judiciary. It is consists of individuals selected to form an authority. This, I think, it could even be considered to be breaking the rule of law, in my mind. Now, finally, talking about the incident in Samos, I was told by the president of Libya that they haven't witnessed any pushback. So probably Mr. Aguilidis' information is wrong, and Mr. Aguilar will reply for himself. But there has been indeed a very peculiar event yesterday in Samos, and I will ask the Attorney General to investigate. What apparently happened, according to our own information, there was an arrival in Samos in the morning of the 3rd of November that was undetected by the Greek authorities. It doesn't mean that we are able to see all arrivals. Some go undetected, unfortunately. Some people hidden in the mountains. There was an individual that approached Libya and said he knows where these people is hiding. And apparently one member of the Libya delegation, just one, with the escort of the Greek police, found these people hiding in the mountains. It is extremely peculiar how a local person knew where the arrival has gone. Very peculiar. But if you ask me why people may be hiding, and I'll conclude with that, under the current Dublin regulation, countries of first registration bear responsibility for this asylum seeker. This is not always to the benefit of the asylum seeker, who prefers to be in Greece undetected, through the same smugglers go to the Western Balkan route and then end up in Central Europe and apply for the first time for asylum in countries like Belgium, Holland, Germany, or Sweden, countries that provide maybe a better benefit environment for him. So people have a big incentive not to be identified to the Greek authorities, so they are not registered, so they can seek asylum to another country. Allowing that will be a breach of our responsibility as Greece under the Dublin regulation. Thank you.
Thank you. On the same incident, Mr. Angelidis continues and addresses a second question on the same incident to Chairman Aguilar. Have you asked the Hellenic Coast Guard for explanations about this case? What specific actions is the Libe Committee going to take about this and other pushback allegations that appear at a rather frantic pace?
Well, as to the witnessing of a pushback live, the short answer is no. So no ground for false assumptions. We have been here 3 days. It would be a false assumption to let the rumor stating that we witnessed an illegal pushback. No, we didn't. But we have for sure stated our mind on the matter in a number of EU resolutions following very intense debate in the plenary of the European Parliament regularly in Strasbourg. I can remind myself and every one of my colleagues making it clear that legal pushbacks must not happen in the European Union, have no place under EU law, that every time there is life in peril at sight, the work to be done is to search and rescue, to bring them ashore and care about the procedure ahead in full compliance with EU law. It's not only my case, it is the case of the European Commission for that matter. I can recall Ylva Johansson going public with that principle time and again. So rest assured, we witnessed no illegal pushback. But having said this, it is also a fact that there is an illicit business model of criminal nature, illicit trafficking of human beings, and exploitation in every possible way, including the most cruel and humane sexual exploitation of women and children. And they have, of course, accomplices within the European Union. There is the general assumption that when we talk about illicit trafficking of human beings, we're talking about some external forces taking place somewhere else. No, they have connections within the European Union, and the criminal deed would not be completed if not because of those who are engaged in criminal activities within the European Union. So yes, we have to crack down on the illicit trafficking of human beings. But by the same token, we have to emphasize regular and legal pathways to make it to Europe. But because you know what? 95% of those who are granted asylum status or some sort of international humanitarian protection within the territory of the European Union, that means within the territory of the member states of the European Union, did make it here irregularly. You know why? Because they were not given the chance to make it regularly. That is why they exposed themselves to the illicit trafficking by the mafia. That is why they exposed themselves to those terrible violations of the most basic fundamental rights. That is why they took the risk of their lives and their loved ones. That is why they took a boat with a terrible nightmare ahead at the risk of perishing and losing their lives. And you know what? They paid for it. They paid for that torture. They paid for that nightmare, an incredible amount of money that will indebt them and their families for life. Why the hell would they do that if they were given the chance to make it regularly? But they were not. So we have to open up legal pathways, Legal migration is needed in the European Union, and there has to be a legal pathway for those in need to make it to Europe regularly. Humanitarian corridors, humanitarian visas, safe pathways to make it to Europe, to bring them, particularly from Afghanistan, which is the number one priority at a humanitarian dimension by now, and let them come to Europe without risking their lives or perishing in the attempt to come ashore. That is also a principle that has been stated in a number of resolutions of the European Parliament. I wanted to share it with you.